and thank you for being here to this topic. And my name is Kuken, I'm from Dr. Company, and I want to share with our experience we had with the composing of enterprise applications on Java and moving them to Docker, and how we face issues, which issues we have. And I want to discuss that with you to know your opinion, to give feedback, to see what you can recommend, what you experience had similar case. So the thing is that it's very popular topic nowadays to talk about Docker, about orchestration system, Kubernetes, Mesosphere. So it's very good if you have application running from scratch, and your project is new, so you can make a design, you can put your microservices on top of Docker, and you can do everything in best trends. But what to do if you have your application legacy, which is developed for 10 years, for 5 years? So I'm sure that every one of you had a situation when you came to a project and you in these days when 2016 and everyone is following new trends, you're forced to have issues which are actually a result of the application that was built many years before. And there, what the problem we had. So yeah, it's small agenda what we're gonna talk today, and the problem was not enough automation. So the problem is how it's nowadays used even for legacy, so everyone has Puppet, Chef, Ansible, so some things that can be that can automate deployments, some application server updates, but still the update with this system isn't so seamless and easy. So it's an issue even now. And factor scale. The issue we faced with WebLogic server, the server was designed for virtual machines, and it wasn't designed to run in containers. So even if we are able to split our application into parts, to divide it into more smaller pieces, it's still runtime still isn't ready for this. And we're trying to decompose this application server to make it more live and run inside the container. So because if you go to for example to a GitHub of Oracle, you will see that the Glassfish server is packed for Docker. You will see that Wildfly is has lighter versions nowadays. But the thing is that some application servers that are packed for Docker as well, they are still heavy enough. So they are not designed for microservices as well. So you just run the container, you can see the full version of Glassfish, there, full version of WebLogic, and it's not super efficient to run them in the way there was, also because of old architecture. So usual case, we had a VM, we had to install admin server, so which will be managing nodes. So we have node manager on top of it. Node manager is managing instances directly. And we have instances that are actually not equally loaded because the design of application. And there, if you need to add extra VMs to your cluster, the usual case that we install VM, add node manager, on top of node manager we had to install instances again, and the story continued. And if you need to scale your application, you had to make your sysadmins, to give your sysadmins extra work to install hardware, to install operating system, to configure everything via Puppet, via Chef. And as a result, you have a cluster, which is working in an old way, so typical legacy Java E cluster, but it is underbalanced. Some nodes are running very small loads, some nodes are overloaded, so you can move your workload from one server to another. So that's a typical issue of virtual machines which is commonly solved nowadays, but you still cannot apply this approach to all Java enterprise applications which are designed in the old way. Wait, so what you cannot do right now with your Java application, which is which was written for many years ago, so you obviously cannot redesign it from scratch. Because if it was written for 10 years ago, it's not something that you can just take a big application to split it into microservices and do it in a good way. So it will take ages. It will take ages. And so another thing, as for scaling, so you cannot reinstall a million of nodes just to keep your load and to reduce this load, which is not needed. So it's also not an option. But there are some things that we're still able to do, to not just to be on the wave of new technology like it should be with if you design an application from scratch, but to shift to this as much as possible. So you are just still running your application in an old way, but it can be much more work in much more efficient way than it was before. So what obviously can be done to achieve this? Today there are hardly to find a reason why to stay on VM instead of container. So we're not just talking about usual Docker containers, but also about any kind of container. So whether they're native LXC or they're JLs in BSD, so there are no reason to hold your application inside a VM unless this is required by your application. For example, it requires something exotic that doesn't support this, or there are another reason that you cannot solve with the container. Because containers nowadays are absolutely can replace for most of applications. So another typical thing. So there are two big actually stories. One story is related to adapt your application to run in more updated way. Another story is to update your runtime. Because, for example, the story with WebLogic, our WebLogic server wasn't ready for running in micro instances. And the big servers like GlassFish and UsualLogic was, they were also not, were actually designed for this. So that's the problem I was talking before. And there's so these issues in the issues were solved actually without our influence related to as for GlassFish, they had Payaga, you might have heard. That's another project that guys were able to minimize GlassFish to consume less resources and to make possible run micro instances for your services just in a place where the huge GlassFish nodes are not needed. The same thing with JWASP, so they did a light version which is JWASP Swarm, gives ability to provision containers with small instances. And another big issue is how to make your application work, because it is a problem to start from the very beginning to decompose all the services from scratch. You obviously had to take the biggest part, the heaviest part, those parts that can be actually moved to separate nodes. And these parts are, I'm not sure that you know that the way how to find it, you need to analyze. So you need to gather metrics. You should see if this part of application consumes a lot of RAM, it makes sense to move this part separately and scale vertically. And in case if this thing is more CPU related and it's possible to make in parallel, it's good to have a layer of horizontally scaled nodes. And this thing takes time. So after you analyze and understand that this application, the way how this application can be treated, you did half of the job. So because that's one of the hardest part. It can take much more time to adopt application server. And in your case, you don't even need anymore to adopt the application server because this job already done for WebLogic. In our case, I will show you the example. And by guys from Bayara project, for those who are running GlassFish in enterprise, and for JWASP Swarm, for those who are running who are running their projects in JWASP. So, As far as your application is divided into parts that are more or less can be scaled vertically and horizontally, you have a cluster that actually can be actually more granular provisioned in your environment. And what we did with JBoss, we adopted this environment to be scalable like this. So without any extra node managers that are used for virtual machines. So admin server is controlling instances directly, so that it gives you ability to be more flexible with your service. And there are some features, not features, but advantages you have. So you have faster provisioning. Provisioning container is much more faster than provisioning a virtual machine. So if you are running Docker with a Docker run command, it takes just seconds to spin up the container. Isolation. So you can put much more services inside one virtual machine inside the hardware server than you will put there via virtual machine. Because virtual machine brings overhead of CPU emulation, and the container has this overhead in time class, because the emulation is still only wasted on namespaces and C groups and namespaces mostly because of isolation layer, and that is much more lower than you should have if you were using virtual machines. So as you can see, you can transform your application into a scalable parts or services. So some services you will have adopted to be grown on vertically, so that means that consume more resources but still remain a single instance. Some services will be scaled horizontally, so you will have more amount of instances but they can work in parallel. And with today's CPUs that has more than 24 cores, it's absolutely very ideal situation when you can use more CPUs than just, and these CPUs will not be in standby because you will be able to divide your load very painful. And what is ideal scaling? Ideal scaling of your Java Enterprise application will be in three directions. So vertical amount of resources per service, horizontal amount of services that is physically possible to divide, because not everything is possible to do in parallel in easy way. And topology, just to split your application as many pieces as it is possible in a short period of time. Because we are not looking at the situation where we need to redesign everything from scratch. And how we did this with WebLogic. So we took their usual image, which was published by the guys on Oracle website. We removed all the complexity, so we don't need the node managers anymore. So we will use that instance only as admin server or instances. We added some scripts, the basic Python script that just running command line to create a cluster and join nodes to existing clusters. And the workflow we just created was like this. So you provision two nodes from the very beginning. One node is admin server, another node is an instance, at least one. And then we have events. So we are developing a cloud platform. We have events. So in case of load will grow on this place, what we gonna do? And we just adding nodes. We're doing scaling, and we're doing scaling out in case load is decreased. So that's a pretty configurable stuff. And the logic inside this engine was built just to scale nodes only instances. So admin servers is not gonna be scaled. And we added some triggers to events. it's very simplistic, but in another engine it's a bit more complex. But anyway, so on install event, when you create a class, we just install, admin serve, and as was on the previous scheme, and on scale in and on scale out, you just manage if the node will be added to the cluster or just moved. I will show you an example. It's better to show than just to tell. So if we take a look to the platform, we can take a link to a manifest, for example, with PyYarn and with WebLogic, and install both of them. So the moment they will be provisioned, I will continue. We'll take PyYarn and Mika. About Gmail, it's working, still working. And one more instance, I will not either, but one more cluster we will install from. So that's just a manifest. Manifest describes topology, basic topology, and the logic. What actions to be done need to be done inside the container in case this container got an event on scale in, on scale down, and to add logic for application server, but also we need a load balancer to manage all of these. And the thing is that, again, if you design your application from scratch, you can use Discovery services and to publish your backends to your key value server, key value known as like console, etcd, and get configure your balancer to get backend for this. But in that case, we are using more simple way just to show that we don't need extra complexity if we try to move application in more efficient way step by step. So we took, again, we got a free HA proxy daughter that was published by that guy, and the HA proxy is very simplistic load balancer. We and the script like is just adding backends and removing backends. And we also connected this script to events. So in case if you added one more application node to a layer, you add it to the backend. And there are two things to use that this flow you don't need to do anymore. So because there are many solutions like this. That one in progress of our installation right now. It's light version of Glassfish. And there about like the bucket swarm is a light version of JBoss. What to expect from tomorrow? So good question. What to do to be on Wave? So if you are running Java EE and you will be able to decompose application to a small part, that doesn't mean that you're you don't have to follow the trends and try to write new microservices in a way it should be. So in the best practices. But the good thing that you still can have efficient cluster even if it's super old. So in our practice, we will be able to run applications that were running for 9 years already, and they were split into parts, and still enough sufficient. So maybe not as perfect as it could be done with super microservice architecture, but at least they are feeling much more better than they were before. And what to expect from tomorrow? So what to do to still keep on the way? We should use new technology. So that way shouldn't be used in case if you are writing something from scratch. So another thing is to use things like Terraform that allows to create infrastructure as a code as well. So if we are writing enterprise code, we need to be absolutely abstract from the hardware. So today, it is possible to provision your infrastructure also as code. So it's a good manner just to be abstract from the admin staff, not writing any scripts, not to add anything. So infrastructure as a code is now also possible. So if you didn't try this, you can go to the Terraform project and see how that can be implemented. So perhaps in future, we will have another kind of Java enterprise package that will also include much more higher level abstraction that will be able to provision the whole application using different data centers, small tenancy. So you just like orchestration and their Java application combined. So the code can be something like this. So when you're writing it, you're just creating an object in your code, so you're just creating the whole clusters. The whole big clusters and containers, so you manage your infrastructure as well as the application inside. So that's one of the things that we have today. And don't be afraid to use new technologies to migrate projects from VMs to containers. There are many ways how to. If you're not even be afraid, if you don't want to try Docker, you can try OpenVZ containers. They are still very efficient and much more better than virtual machines. And that was our experience. So I would like also to hear from you what kind of experience did you have to decompose big applications. So if you have any questions, please. Is anyone from you is using Kubernetes or Mesosphere as orchestration for Docker? For microservices? No?
Yes, please. We use JLastic once to deploy Java applications.
Yeah.
Now it's like if you move to Docker application, Docker or containers.
Only as a Steam fleet. So what we need is, I will show you JLastic so you can see there are the topology. and we can scale amount of nodes here, the same as for JBoss. JBoss, same for WebLogic, and I will install text layer just in a minute. So yeah, we were first this platform as a service that was running also on top of containers, but these containers were just OpenVZ containers with software, installed software inside, and Logic that is managing deployment of Java applications. But later we changed default Docker images and inject this logic directly there. So now we can provision Docker containers with like a smart Docker container, not usual image that can test only entry point and CMD, so you can just start the application. Mm-hmm. But the good thing that application can also have with itself logic how to manage itself. And so now the direction we are working, we're just trying to inject such kind of logic in Docker. So because one thing is also about efficiency. So sometimes if you run your application even with Docker, the deployment of whole application server with application deployed inside may be not a very good approach. Perhaps it's better to replace just a WAR file inside the container than just to deploy the whole container. So that's kind of logic that can come with this. Or just do some connections, some discovery, etc. And as for layers, one example of the just a second, I will scale the layers. What I can show on another example. So you can see the application is a set of layers. And these layers can be scaled. But the thing is that you can create, so the thing is that we should not just think by containers, but we should think by layers. So working using containers as a single node is not a good approach. So that everything should be about layers, about scalable layers. So in general, application topology can be like a multi-directional layer form. So it's just Because there are no reason to use, even if you need only a single instance of something very big that is scaling vertically, it also will be a layer with one node. And the thing that the resolution doesn't allow to show you scaling options, so how to trigger this. Microservices that are connected to a cluster with the logic similar to this that I showed on WebLogic. So we will push our class. The thing is that containers can be self connected with such kind of scripts, and the way that can bring enterprise application to a server without extra complexity, because the idea is that Docker is still something that people are afraid of, because it has to be special software installed, so you cannot enter just the container and feel as in cold way just if you are just configuring usual Unix machine or Linux machine. And if you will try to use OpenVZ containers instead, that's also compatible with Docker, so that can be easier way to jump from one level to another level, because their approach is very similar, but it's still very similar to virtual machine. But the thing is that it's container. So it's not a virtual machine, but container. And it is already by default much more efficient. You can scale resources on fly, you can add memory, remove memory, add CPU cores, remove CPU cores. So containers opens big ability. Also for continuous delivery, continuous integration, managing things with big parts, sometimes much more easier in results. Something like this. Thank you for wasting your time listening to me and don't pushing me. So I started from such a painful view, but the topic is really important. If you need to migrate application from old wave to new wave, but this new wave isn't working for applications that are written in the old standard. If you have any experience, please, I would be glad to hear feedback on what we did wrong, what we did right, please.